Hello friends, good morning to all. Today we are going to see the remaining part of second chapter in agriculture in Maharashtra. So let us see which are the major food crops in Maharashtra. We have to discuss bajra and jowar crops which are grown in important area or many areas of Maharashtra. So let us see about the bajra. Bajra is the main crop, and particularly in the rural areas, bajra crop or bajra food grain is preferred in the diet. It is known as pearl millet. It is a staple food crop of poor farmers. As you know that there is no affordable capacity of the poor farmers to purchase important crops or which is having high prices, so that bajra crop is preferred by the poor farmers. Grown in both kharif and rabi season, not only in the rainy, but it is also grown in winter season. Wherever there is the availability of the irrigation facility, the bajra crop is grown using the irrigation facility. The most important characteristics of this crop is it is adaptive and susceptible to any climate. It means, suppose if there is a heavy rainfall, then also it can survive, and at the same time if there is a shortage or if there is a break in the monsoon, then also it can survive. So it is adaptive in the sense it can adapt to the climate, which is although it is severe or although it is a harsh climatic condition. So, and not only adaptive, but it is susceptible, means it can have a resistance to survive at any climate. So it is adaptive and susceptible to any climate. So which are the geographical requirements for the cultivation of bajra? Let us see. Temperature required for the bajra growing is 26 degrees Celsius, which is commonly available throughout the part of Maharashtra, and that's why bajra is the main crop in Maharashtra. Rainfall is required, moderate amount of rainfall, 75 to 100 centimeter rainfall is required. Although it is less than this, and although if the rainfall is more than this range, then also it can grow, or then also it can susceptible or adapt the rainfall condition. So which type of soil is required for the bajra? As I already explained, that it is adaptive and susceptible to the climate, then it is also susceptible to the soil. Even medium fertile soil is required, can grow in low pH and high salinity. So although the soil is not fertile, and although the soil is not enriched, then also it can grow, and which is helpful for the farmer. Any land is useful, means although there is a undulation, although there is a low depth of the soil, although there is a no any facility of the irrigation, then also it can grow the bajra. Fertilizer. Not specific type of fertilizers are required for the growing of the bajra. Only optimum level should be maintained by the farmers, so that bajra can grow at an optimum level of availability of the fertilizers. So this is all about the geographical factors required for the bajra. Distribution of bajra. So let us see wherever the bajra crops are grown. So the important areas are Tapi and Godavari Valley. As you know that there is a fertile soil or the favorable condition for the growing of any crop, and that's why bajra mainly grown in Tapi and Godavari Valley. The important districts are Ahmednagar, Dhule, Nasik, Nandurbar, Aurangabad, Bid, Pune. These are the leading or the important districts wherever the bajra crops are grown. Nashik district is leading producer of bajra because the soil or particular favorable condition is available in the Nashik district, and that's why Nashik district, particularly Sinnar, Evla, Nandgaon, these tehsils, Malegaon even, these tehsils have most important growing region of the bajra. So if you see the importance of bajra for health, then we realize that it is a good source of energy. Particularly in the winter season, we can take food that is bajra, because it is warm and keep body warmer. It also promotes health of the heart, because the availability because whatever the contents available in the bajra, they helps to promote the health of the heart. It not only helpful for the heart, but it reduces the weight, because it is easy to digest and easy to eat, so it is reduces weight. And so at the same time, there is no any fat available in the bajra. It helps in digestion disorder. It prevents cancer. The most important thing is that it prevents cancer. At the same time, it controls the blood sugar. Whatever the sugar level should be there as per the as per the fitness, then the bajra controls the blood sugar. So these all are the importance of bajra for the health. So let us see the next crop, that is jowar. Major crop. This is also one major crop. It covers 29% to 32% of the gross crop area, grown in both kharif and rabi season. As I already explained, it is grown in winter as well as in rabi season. Which geographical requirements for the cultivation of jowar is there? Let us see. Temperature is required 26 degrees Celsius. Rainfall is required moderate amount rainfall, 75 to 100 centimeters. Soil required for the jowar is medium fertile soil. As compared to the bajra, it requires a medium fertile soil, not very high quality soil, and enriched soil is required. Land, any land means, although there is a undulation, although it is a plateau, and although there is a plain area, then also we can grow a jowar crop. Fertilizer is optimum, not specific NPK or secondary nutrients and micronutrients are required for the growing of jowar, but at optimum level of availability, helpful for the growing of the jowar crops. So let us see where these crops is grown. Tapi, Purna, Bhima, Vardha, Painganga valleys are important. So for the distribution or the growing areas of jowar is concerned. In Marathwada, there is the Usmanabad and Bid districts where there is a crop which grown in these areas. Solapur, Ahmednagar, Dhulia, Nandurbar, Jalgaon, Pune, Satara, Sangli district have concentration of jowar. So this crop is also very easy to digest and very easy to grow even. Not only these areas, but in Khandesh, Rabi jowar is called as Dadar. That is a local name or native name. In Maharashtra, Marathwada, it is called Shalu, while it is called Maldandi in Solapur district. These are the local names of jowar. So jowar is also important crop in Maharashtra, and which is grown throughout the part except Kokan and except some patches of the Maharashtra. But this is the well-known and very popular crop so far, the major crops in Maharashtra is concerned. So today we stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.